Pretty girl. Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. If it's your first time joining me, my name is Lazi, and if you're coming back, you're touching that video, welcome home, pretty gang. So on today's video, I've decided to jump in into the true crime section. I love true crime. I'm always watching true crime. So I'm like, I could just watch and be getting some content for my channel because I shim dia goisha when it comes to my YouTube channel. I release like a video once in a month and I don't like that. So I decided to jump in on to true crime. So but there's gonna be a twist to it. So there's one of my favorite true crime storytellers. Her name is Baby Siren. She tells like American true crime stories, but I always watch her on Facebook. But yeah, so that's where my inspiration comes from. So I'm gonna be beating my face and telling you guys the story, right? Cool. Sharp. Without talking too much, let's jump straight into the video. So today's story is about Zephanie Nurse. So this story has me wondering if Blood and Water was based on a true story. So Zephanie Nurse was born on the 28th of April back in 1997 in Cape Town, South Africa. Celeste Nurse gave birth via cesarean section at Portershire Hospital in Cape Town. Celeste says she remembers a woman dressed in a nurse's uniform comforting her while her baby was still in a baby cot before she fell asleep. I mean, she had just had a baby. I could imagine she was tired, so she fell asleep and Zephanie was still in her baby cot. Sadly, that will be the last time Celeste sees her baby girl. Upon waking up, she remembers a nurse asking her like, where's the baby? And she was like, what do you mean, where's the baby? So she took a glance at the baby cord and Zephanie wasn't there. It was at this point that Celeste knew that her baby was missing. So they started searching the entire hospital for the baby. The police were called, started looking for her, searching the maternity ward, searching the entire hospital, but to no luck. Police found some untraceable items. They also found some baby clothes, and a pillow was found in this shady tunnel that was in the hospital. So the tunnel was said to lead into the maternity ward from outside. So they believed that the kidnapper used that tunnel, and they found a pillow in that tunnel. So they thought that the pillow was used as a fake pregnancy, because who would question a pregnant woman moving around the maternity ward? She looked like a patient, so that's what the police believe. So upon searching and asking everybody, like, did you see any woman with the child? Did you see anyone looking suspicious? This woman, who had also just given birth, says she remembers a woman dressed in nurse's uniform. She walked in on her while she was holding her baby, and then she asked her like, yo, what are you doing? And then she said, no, the baby was crying, so I was comforting the baby. It's not like I'm gonna steal the baby or anything. I'm kidding, that's not what she said. She didn't say that, but yeah, she's like, no, I was just comforting the baby, you know. So that got Celeste to believe that it is not like her baby was targeted. This lady just wanted to steal a child. Like, any child. It didn't matter. This person just wanted to steal a child. 5 days later, the nurses went home without their baby girl. So they just left because, like, the police searched everywhere and there was no sign of Zephany. So the nurse's family just left the hospital. I mean, it must have been devastating for them. And on the other side, a lady by the name of Lovana Solomon went home to her husband, Michael Solomon. She just got home with a beautiful baby girl and they named her Misha. Misha or Mish, I don't know how to pronounce her name. Misha. 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 I'm gonna call her Misha. Misha Solomon. And so I guess Lovana didn't explain to her husband what actually happened, because Ross said that she actually got a miscarriage, right? She said she got a miscarriage and then she adopted Zephany, but she didn't tell that to her husband. So another thing is that the nurses had a second child and they called her Cassidy Nurse. So Cassidy was about to start high school. I think she was just starting a new school, and coincidentally that's where Mish Solomon also attended. So, like, Misha's friends, they will tell her that, oh my god, there's this kid in grade 8, she looks exactly like you, like you'd say you guys are sisters. So Mish grew curious. She wanted to, like, see this girl who everybody says she looks like. So she met Cassidy one day, and she says that the first time she met Cassidy, she just developed this strong sisterly bond towards her. Like, she didn't know what it was, she couldn't even explain the feeling, but she just, I don't know, she said she felt like she had known her entire life, but it was the first time seeing her, right? So, and then, you know, they just became friends, they became close, despite their age gap. I mean, Misha was in matric and Cassidy was in grade 8, so despite that age gap, they became friends. They were so close, and funny that they called each other sisters. Like, Cassidy would call Mish the big sister, and Misha would call Cassidy, like, oh, she's my little sister. Talk about the universe just knowing how to put things together, right? Thus, one day, as they're, like, hanging out, you know, doing their best friend things, they took a selfie. But now, This selfie is crucial. This selfie is of paramount importance. This selfie is, this is a selfie that they call the selfie that brought Zephany home. That's how serious this selfie is. But like, when they took it, I don't think they didn't think anything of it. So they took the selfie. Mish took the selfie home to show her parents. I guess her parents just brushed it off, like, oh, okay, whatever, oh, she's your friend, oh, cute, because they didn't want anybody to know the truth. But when Cassidy showed her parents the selfie, it was that what moment. Like, I'm gonna put the selfie somewhere here so you guys can see how, like, the resemblance. They literally look like one person. Like, the resemblance is shocking. And there's no way Cassidy's parents would just sit around and do nothing. I mean, they lost a child for 17 years. But just like in Blood and Water, the nurse's family would celebrate Zaphany's birthday like every year. I think they hoped that one day she'll return home and they'll be able to celebrate her birthday with her. So I thought of saying that when Cassidy took the selfie home, her dad had a very strong belief. Actually, everybody in the whole house, they had a very strong belief that this could be Zaphany, the daughter they lost 17 years ago. So Cassidy's dad asked to meet up with Mish. So she told Cassidy that I would actually like to meet her, right? So Mish was like, oh, okay, cool, no problem. So she arranged for them to meet. And when Cassidy's dad saw Misha for the first time, he knew, like deep down in his gut, he knew when he saw her, he was like shocked, he was flabbergasted, he was like jaw dropped, like there's no way. This kid looks exactly like my child Cassidy. So he believed that this was Zaphany. So he got in contact with the police for them to reopen the case. I mean, although they had so much belief, they believed that that was Zaphany, there was other times when they thought that they had found her, because someone called and like, oh, I know where your daughter is. And it turned out it wasn't her. And then the second time, also something similar happened, and they asked for 500k. Imagine. And turns out nothing, unfortunately nothing. They couldn't find Zaphany. So this time around, but her dad, like Cassidy's dad, really believed that this time around they have found her. A couple of weeks later, after the investigation was reopened, Mish was in class when she got called to the principal's office. So Mish was called to the principal's office, and when she got there, there were two social workers waiting for her in the principal's office. When she got there, they all asked her if she had ever heard about the kidnapping of baby Zaphany, and then she said no, like she's never heard of the case. And then the social workers told her that, oh, okay, well, we think that you are, we think that you are that baby. I don't know how I would react if they were to tell me that. I don't know. Mish was like, ain't no way I could be that baby. I wasn't born at Rotorshire Hospital. I was actually born at the Retreat Day Hospital. And then the social workers told her that, actually there's no record of you being born at Retreat Day Hospital. And Retreat Day Hospital, it was like a 20-minute drive. So after telling Mish that there was no record of her being born at Retreat Day Hospital, they took Misha's DNA and they ran it against Cassidy's parents. They ran it against Celeste and her husband. And the results, they came out positive. So Misha was indeed baby Zaphany that was kidnapped 17 years ago. So after this, they took Misha to a safe house, and she said like when she was there, she was very confused, and she just didn't know what to do. And all she wanted was to go home to her parents, Lovana Solomon and Michael Solomon. Those are the parents she knew. Those are the people that raised her. So she just wanted to go home to them. I mean, I really understand how she would feel. Like, regardless of her being kidnapped, those are the only people she knew as her parents. And now you just discover that those are not your parents and you're actually kidnapped as a baby. Like, she wasn't allowed to go home. They just kept her there. And on the other side, the nurses were excited. I mean, they were thrilled. They have finally found their baby. They finally found baby Zephanie that they lost like 17 years ago. I mean, finally, they have celebrated her birthday all these years without her being present. So this discovery, just, I guess they thought that now she could be with us. Now she could be home with us and we can celebrate her birthday while she's around. Misha said that the first time she met like her biological parents, she didn't feel like anything. Remember when she met Cassidy, she said she felt like she has known her entire life. But when she met her biological parents, she said she didn't feel anything. She didn't have any like emotion towards them. She said she just felt sorry for them that they had like this traumatic experience. She just felt sorry for them, but she didn't like, you know, acknowledge that these are her biological parents. She said she was surprised that why are they crying, you know, they were crying, they were hugging her, like, oh my god, we have searched for you for so long. But she was just confused. She didn't know what to do. She didn't know how to feel. She was it wasn't sinking in for her, which I understand. I mean, 17 years, it's a long time. 17 years. She mentioned that she didn't understand why they kept calling her like Zephanie, because her name was Misha. So why were they calling her Zephanie? Like, oh my god, Zephanie, you're home. She didn't understand that. So when Misha was kidnapped, she was still a minor. So her name was not published to the public. So I guess it was just a baby. Like, she went to court 4 years later. She went to court and then she told them that it's okay, you can publish my name to the public. So the court released the ban from her name not being released to the public. So her name was released to the public. Like, things just didn't go smooth sailing. I guess the nurses didn't get that reunion that they were hoping for. Like, things just didn't go very smooth. Misha didn't automatically just return home and went back home and stayed with the nurses. I guess she was just in so much confusion, which I understand it. And like, I really get it. It was reported that drama after drama just kept on happening around this whole saga, and also Cassidy and Misha's friendship kind of like crumbled. Lovana Solomon, she was then sentenced to 10 years in prison for kidnapping baby Zephanie, and her husband Michael, he wasn't charged with anything because he didn't have any involvement in this. He was shocked finding out that Misha was in fact not his child, I guess. And Lovana claimed that she was innocent, like she didn't know anything about kidnapping, like she never kidnapped baby Zephyr. She claims that the baby was given to her via adoption, like some sort of illegal adoption. Some lady just like, she bought the baby or something, and that claim was literally thrown out. Like, Girl, no, we don't believe you. She mentioned a name that this lady was the lady that gave her the baby, but upon investigation, there was no sign of this lady, like even at the hospital or anything like that. So they just threw out her claim. She couldn't also like provide any evidence to support her claim about adoption. So in 2019 August, Misha Solomon released a book called Zephany, Two Mothers, One Daughter. The book is said to be available at Takealot if you want to read it. So yes guys, we have come to the end of the video. I just want to add class just for the fun of it. Yes guys, we have come to the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and leave a comment down below about what you think about the story, and I will see you guys on my next upload. I love you. Bye.